Have you been?
I can't complain. Ohio.
You going back to Japan? How do you feel?
Well, we've been waiting now for 2 years to come back to Japan. It's been a real long wait. Japan is probably Quiet Riot's favorite place to play, mostly because the fans are so grateful and they know the songs and everything. So getting back to Japan is going to be a lot of fun for us. We're looking forward to it.
あのニューアルバム QR の話をさせてもらいたいんですけども、 QR って割と、ブルースとかリズム&ブルースっぽい曲も結構入っていたりして、新しいクワイエット・ライオットのイメージを訴えているような気がしますけども、その辺いかがでしょうか。
Well, what happened is if you listen to some of the older Quiet Riot songs, for instance, a song like Don't Want to Let You Go off of Mental Health, or a song like Condition Critical off of Condition Critical, or a song like The Pump off of QR3, they always had that sort of blues rockkind of feel about it, but with a vocalist like Kevin Dubrow, it changed it from blues to more of a pop rock sort of feel. So when we decided to no longer work with Kevin and we decided to get Paul Shortino in the band, it made sense because Paul has a very blues oriented voice. And what happened is when we started working together nearly 2 years ago writing songs, all the songs evolved into that directionNow, Paul has a lot to do with it because anytime, you know, you have a vocalist singing, he's going to obviously change the sound of the band to a certain degree. But that was the direction that the band was going into anyway. He was just very helpful.
Quiet Riot に限らず最近、ブルースとかリズム&ブルースのルーツに戻ろうとするバンドが非常にアメリカに多くなってきましたよね。これは一つのやっぱり現象というか流れなんでしょうか。
I think what happens is when anytime you get...a band that makes a huge impact on the sort of music place like Whitesnake did, it's something that everybody says, that's great. And it's not like you're trying to copy Whitesnake, but you like something so much that you sort of tend to veer in that direction. And I see that happening with a lot of bands. I mean, some of the stuff on the new Europe record sounds to me very influenced by that whole blues rock sort of thing.So it's, I think it's just a natural progression. The thing you got to remember about American music and English music is that the blues has always been a foundation. And so you have bands that like come out this year that are very blues oriented. And then maybe 2 or 3 years from now, that won't be that popular anymore. But then 2 or 3 years later, the blues thing will come back again. So it's kind of like the thread in the cloth. You know, it's constantly going to be there.
ところでバンドは QR を出してから実際コンサートはプロモーションツアーみたいなものはもうすでに行ってるんですか。
Well, what we did is we did some promotional stuff here in the States, but it was like non-playing. It was going to different cities, you know, and talking to the fans and talking to radio and things like that. And then when we knew we were going to go over to Japan, since we have been off virtually for almost 2 years,What we did is we had an opportunity to play in Colombia and South America. So what we did is we went over there and did those shows sort of as a warm-up for the Japanese tour.
あの、日本では噂が流れてて、フランキーはクワイエット・ライオットを脱退してワスプに入るんじゃないかという噂も実は出てるんですけど、その辺の真相について教えていただけますか。
No, you know, the thing about me is, as a musician, I always want to improve. And the only way I can improve is to, when I have time off from Quiet Riot, is to be able to do different projects and different styles of music. So, I'm always working. I mean, I take no days off. You know, I take a vacation once a year. The rest of the time I'm playing drums, whether it's something big or something small, all the time I'm working. So what happened is I've known Blackie for about 12 years because I met him when I first came out to Los Angeles. And 12 years ago, he said, you know, maybe one day we'll get together and play. I had no idea it was going to take 12 years. So last year when he asked me if I would do the drums on the Wasp album, I agreed to do it. And, they auditioned a lot of drummers to go on their European tour, and they had a lot of problems finding a drummer they were happy with. So they asked me if I could do the tour. And the tour was going to start at the same time as Quiet Riot's Japanese tour. So I said I couldn't do it. And I guess they wanted me bad enough because they postponed their European tour so that I could do the Quiet Riot tour. But I'm taking off 6 to 8 weeks from Quiet Riot at the end of our Japanese tour and going straight over to London. and I'll start the Wasp tour over there. But it's not that I'm leaving Quiet Riot unless something happens that I don't know of. But I'm not planning to leave Quiet Riot. I just love to work.
Wasp の方からアメリカツアーも同行してほしいって話が出たらどうしますか？
That's impossible for me to really say whether I would do that or not because there's a lot of things that I still want to accomplish with Quiet Riot and there's a lot of other projects that I can go into. For instance, I just finished doing the new album for Alex Mossi, an Italian sort of rock fusion, sort of heavy metal guitarist. And I'm real happy with that because I got to work with one of my all-time heroes, guitarist Alan Holdsworth. So that was a lot of fun. And I heard through my office that Y&T are interested in having me do some tracks on their record. So, you know, since I like to work so much, it's impossible for me to say what I'm going to do musically. I have no desire to leave Quiet Riot because I've been in Quiet Riot now for 9 years. And I've put an awful lot of work into Quiet Riot.